Right, we're gonna do a couple experiments. We're gonna purposely blow these mortars up. But I only have one. We're gonna do it with a couple shells. This is a 10 break shell. This was out years ago. This is a Shogun item. And if I remember the story right, the Shogun guy said they were initially gonna make an 8 break shell, but they thought if they made an 8 break shell, another competitor would make a 10 break shell. So they made a 10 break, and a competitor made a 12 break. These actually never caught on in popularity. They're you know, just a bunch of breaks are kind of weak. And when they first came out with it, it stuck out of the mortar this much and it couldn't pass the inspection, so they had to make the mortar longer. So I'm gonna light one just for you to see what it looks like. And then once we get going, we're gonna get this same 10 break shell. We're gonna, with the second one, and we're gonna purposely shoot it upside down just to see how these fiberglass mortars behave. And I'm gonna shoot a double break shell, a single break, and whatever else I got, we'll take a look to see how a fiberglass mortar behaves when something blows up in it. And I got a cardboard one, we should have got that one too. So let me just shoot one of these for the heck of it and see what it looks like. It makes a hell of a kick when it goes off. It looks like that shell they shot at the Cracker Jack, so it was like 24 break.
So you guys want to walk back?
All right, so I'm going to need a little time to set this experiment up, and then we'll get
back. Okay, we're going
to
set this up. Fiberglass, fiberglass, fiberglass. That's cardboard, and this is fiberglass. It was really work to defeat the purpose of the fuse. It's harder to do. It's not a thing that's naturally going to happen. This is a canister shell. This is Biggs Pro. This is a Weapons of Bay Wolf shell. So you have to push it in. It's just not naturally going to fall into that. Unless you use a little bit bigger one, it might. But and this one will be Weapons of Bay Wolf. This one will be the double break. Let's see. It'll be this one, the double break window product. So it's Biggs, Weapons of Bay Wolf, double break, and the Decimator, the 10 break shell. And we're going to set it up one at a time and shoot it. Okay, here's the first one upside down in a fiberglass mortar. Made short work of that tube and knocked one loose beside it. This is why I didn't load them all. Okay, we'll move into another one. Okay, I'm doing this under controlled conditions as best I can. And they told me to move back a little further because it went a little further than we thought. This gives you an idea what it'll do, how it shreds. I heard it would powder. But it didn't. It shredded and blew right where it was. All right, let me move back further and we'll do another one. What else I noticed was it actually broke the brick in half that I was using to help stabilize it. So it's pretty damn potent. Okay, this is a canister artillery shell, Weapons of Bay Wolf, upside down. In a cardboard mortar. here's the, that's probably the clay that's part of the shell, the top of the shell. And here's the mortar, cardboard. Okay, now, see what we're gonna do next. Next video is window, two breaks with a mine, upside down.
Fiberglass mortar.
Not sure how much of it showed, but I did definitely place it in there upside down, and the mortar tube survived, and it almost behaved like a double shot mine. When it come out of the pipe, I know I didn't have a long shot view of it. Okay, let's do the next one. Here's something interesting. I had this placed on the ground, and it drove, wow, that pipe's hot, it drove it into the ground. It broke the base, drove it straight down into the ground, but it survived. Set the next one up. Okay, the final one is Decimator. This one's no longer made. It's the Shogun product. It's a 10 break shell. So we'll see how this one behaves. It has its own special mortar, and the mortar is fiberglass. Upside down. Pin break. I actually might like that shell better upside down. Well, it didn't blow the mortar, so what do we know? We know that the smaller multi-break shells probably are not going to blow a fiberglass mortar, but a canister shell will definitely blow it apart. So I hope you enjoyed it. Upside down fireworks.